Hey, what's up guys, this is Saurav here from TechYard, and in this video I will be showing you some features as well as some tips and tricks for the Xiaomi A1. Now, as we all know that it is running on stock Nougat, so we don't get a lot of customization, but the first thing that I am going to show you is the Google Cards. Swipe left and you will get the Google app, or what we call it a Google Cards at times, and it is a very good thing. You can search anything from here on, and then you will, you know, get those search results in browser. And there is an also option of the OK Google, so you can easily, you know, make your assistant more comfortable with you. I actually flirt a lot with the Google Assistant and the replies are awesome. Google Assistant is really a badass girl. Yeah, it's a girl. Anyways guys, you can easily, you know, make use of Google Assistant by your own way, so that's entirely up to you. Now, the second thing that I will be showing you is how to rotate your home screen. But in order to do that, you have to go to the drop down menu and select the auto rotate mode. Now, this is mandatory to do this. Now, then tap for a few seconds, and then you will be heading to the settings option of the launcher and select the auto rotation. And then you will see that the home screen has been rotated as per the rotation. So one thing for people who are actually using the phone while sleeping, or they're resting on the couch or like that, this is a very good way to handle your phone. And by swiping up from the downside, you will get the app drawer as well. So that's a very good feature for a lot of people. Now, we don't get the battery percentage numbers on the icon. We have to assume how much battery left there, but you can easily change it. Select the settings icon and tap it for a few seconds. I mean, press it for a few seconds. And then you will be you will see that the system UI tuner has been added to the settings kind of a notification. Open the system UI tuner, just press on the understood, and I'm giving you a caution guys, if you don't know what to do, just don't do that. That's the best thing for you to save your phone. So here are some auto rotate screen option, headset option that you should keep disabled. Now there is the battery option, select here and you will get the always show percentage option. Select it. And you will see that the battery percentage number is actually currently inside the battery icon. Now we don't get the setting, we don't get the seconds in the case of time, but you can change that. Select the show hours, minutes and seconds option, and you will see that the time is 12:51, 23 seconds. So actually I don't like this. I'm happy with the previous one, so I'm gonna go back to the default. But if you love that feature, yes, just go for it guys. Now there is the power notification controls. If you really know about it, then use it. If you don't know, just leave it. Leave it like it is. Now, there is another thing that you can do with the fingerprint scanner, and there is a dedicated gesture to it. Swipe it down and you will get the, you can easily swipe down the notification panel. I will show you that. Now, there is the gesture option in the settings. There are basically two gestures that you can do. Swipe for notification, and I will show you that right now. I'm swiping down over the fingerprint scanner. So swipe down in this way. And you will see the notification panel will swipe down. You can see it is very good for a lot of times when you don't want to use both of your hands to hold the to use the phone, and you can easily use it. That's a very good thing. And now swipe it up and the notification panel will go up. That's how it works. And there is another option of jump to camera. Now select it first of all, enable it, then press the power button twice, and wherever you are, it will go to the camera app. Now the camera app, I will make a dedicated video on the camera app very soon. Don't worry guys, it is taking a bit of time because I got the phone 3 days later of the actual launch, so I'm a bit late than the other YouTubers. Now guys, coming to the mode of the cellular network settings, there is a three dedicated option of 4G, 3G and 2G, but I have seen that there is no 4G only mode. So if you are selected on the 4G, but if there is no 4G network, it will automatically switch to the 3G mode. I hope a lot of people don't know about it, so I thought of, you know, sharing this with your friends. So guys, if you are on 4G, if you selected the 4G, but it will automatically switch to 3G if 4G is not available there. And there is a VPN. If you know how to use VPN, then yes, always use VPN. That's way more secure for transactions. Now there we get the screen saver option. There are a lot of options guys, like clock, colors, photo frame, photo table. Now I'm selecting the start now with the clock. Okay, start with the photo table. And there you get the option of selecting which photos you want to select for the photo table, and then select start now. And you will see a lot of photos are actually coming here from the folders that you selected, and it looks great. There are options where you can actually automatically enable them while docked or while charging. So select while charging. And you will see that when your phone actually getting charged, that kind of effect will come to your device. And then there is the clock, and it will actually what happen when you select the while charging or while docking. If your phone is getting charged, it will show a time like this. I'm just showing you the preview, but you can easily select when you want that. You can easily use start now and keep the phone like this, or you can easily select the particular timing like charging, and then it will start automatically. And there is the photos, and you can select which photos to select and which photos not to select. Entirely up to you. So this is how it more or less work, guys. So I'm gonna stick to the clock because I love the clock. I don't love the photo table that much. I love the clock way better than that. Now there is the font size. You can easily change the font size as per your choice. So entirely depends on your preference, but I love the display size. It was also there in the G5S Plus, and it is still also here. Now in this case of display size, not only the icons get bigger, not only the fonts get bigger, both of them actually goes bigger. And for people who are actually a bit old and using a device like this, for them it is really very much beneficiary. For me, I'm happy with the default, so I have no issues with it. But for people who are a bit old, for people whose hands shake a lot while touching the display, a bigger icon will be way more beneficiary to you all. So it's a very good feature, and anyone of any age can use the device. So there is the option of adaptive brightness, and we also get the option of live wallpapers. Unfortunately, there are no live wallpapers pre-installed, but you can easily download any live wallpaper from the Play Store or any other app as per your choice. Now there are some wallpapers that you can select, and you can select it for either the wallpaper or the lock screen or for the both. Now there is the ambient display, guys. There is a very good thing. First of all, I have to disable it to show it how it works, because that's important. Suppose your phone is locked and someone has sent you a Facebook someone has sent you send anything from Facebook or Messenger. Like you can see, Pratika sent me a message. So you can see it didn't glow like that. I have to manually unlock it. But suppose that is turned on, and you will see a dark screen like this appears. Actually, it looks like this. I have taken another picture of it. So it looks great, guys. Even in dark environment, it gives a edgy look to your phone. And this is, I believe, the best feature that I've seen on the A1. That, ambient display, that is really good. Now, guys, you can easily edit how many icons you want in the drop-down menu. And there is the option of adding a guest or add a separate user. You add a separate user, and whenever that user uses his profile or her profile, your phone will be entirely changed. The icons will be changed, the Facebook, everything will be changed as per his or her choice. Now, you can easily reposition all these icons as per your choice, or add any other icons if you want them. But I'm not very happy because I don't get the option of choose any app shortcut that I want from here, and that is kind of a deal breaker for me. But it's okay. After I root it, I'll get to do anything I want, because that's what I do. That's what TakeCare does, isn't it? Anyways, we get a lot of options right there. And guys, there is the schedule power on and off option. If you fell asleep and forget to switch off your device, it will automatically switch off your device and automatically switch it on. And there is the Android version option. You can easily check for update from here. But as of now, I haven't got any update. The last update I got was the security patch level update, and it is updated to August. So I believe in September we'll get a in November I will get a new so October I will get a new update, I believe. So in October or November, like that. And in case of the camera, I will do a dedicated camera app review, don't worry. But there are two things that you should check for. Actually, first of all is the the portrait mode, and there another one is the telephoto option. So select the 1x 2x and it will zoom 2x without any actual loss in quality. That's a very good thing. So this is all for today, guys, more or less. I hope you love this video. If you really loved it, vote it up, share with your friends, and if you don't like it, dislike it if you want it. So subscribe to our channel, hit the bell icon to get instant notification. Till then, bye. People, have a great day ahead. Hope to see you in my next video. Stay awesome, stay subscribed. Bye bye now.